Hi, welcome back. This is Rakesh Naik. Sorry, I couldn't post any video for you last week. It happens sometimes, something is beyond our control. This week, I'm posting this video for you people, those who are waiting for my videos. Today, we are going to discuss about a randomized algorithm. Before we start randomized algorithm, let us see what is deterministic algorithm. Basically, deterministic algorithms are the most studied and familiar kind of algorithm, as well as one of the most practical, since they can be run on a real machine very efficiently. And if you want to define deterministic algorithm, it can go like this: an algorithm whose behavior can be completely predicted from the input. I'll say those kind of algorithms as deterministic algorithms. To understand that, let us say we are having an algorithm. For that algorithm, we are giving some kind of input and we are getting some kind of an output. And we can exactly say what kind of output we can get with a given input. A deterministic algorithm is an algorithm which, given a particular input, it always produces the same output with the underlying machine, always passes through the same sequence of states. And a deterministic algorithm computes a mathematical function. A function has a unique value for any input in its domain. And the algorithm is a process that produces a particular value as an output. Let us see this particular function. Function which is finding a particular value is even or odd. So how generally we do? We are having a variable that we are passing in the particular function, and we are taking mod 2. If it is returning 1, it means it is an odd value, and when it is returning 0 or any other value, it is returning false. And look at this function, is odd. Here you can see a parameter n is passed and we are taking n mod 2. When we are taking n mod 2, if the output is 1, then it is returning true. It means the value is odd, otherwise the value is false. So for any set of input that we are inputting here, the output becomes 0 or 1, depending on the value is odd or even. So like that, depending on the input, we can predict the output. So what makes the algorithm non-deterministic? A variety of factors can cause an algorithm to behave in a way which is not deterministic or non-deterministic. If it uses external state other than the input, such as user input, a global variable, a hardware timer value, or a random value, or a stored disk data, if it operates in a way that is timing sensitive. For example, if it has multiple processors writing on the same data at the same time, in this case, the precise order in which each processor writes its data will affect the result. A hardware error also causes the state to change in an unexpected way. So these are some factors which makes a algorithm non-deterministic. Generally, we termed it as randomized analysis or randomized algorithm. A randomized algorithm is one that makes use of a randomizer. Some of the decision taken in the algorithm depends on the output of the randomizer. If the algorithm is given and we are given with the input, we generally get an output. But if the output depends on the output of the randomizer, then we'll say such kind of an algorithm as a randomized algorithm. For that, we need a random number, and the randomizer generates me a random number. Basically, a randomizer is a program, and as it is a program, it has to be deterministic. So that's why we call the value that is generated from a randomizer as a pseudo random number, which is not exact random number. You can see this. If I want to generate a random number, then it can be same. You can never say the same number will never be getting generated. So a number is a number. By looking at the number, you cannot tell how it was generated. So pseudo-random numbers are random numbers whose property approximate the properties of a sequence of random numbers. So pseudo-random numbers basically are the number that are not truly random because it is completely determined by a set of initial values. And a truly random number, on the other hand, is completely unpredictable. The usual way to flip a coin or throwing a dart or rolling a dice, all these things give me a true random number. But when we generate a random number to a program, we say it as a pseudo random number. Here we are going to discuss one simple algorithm to generate pseudo random number. You can see a linear congruence method is very widely used and they require the choice of two members, M and B. For any seeding number or starting number A, we generate the next number in the sequence A cross B plus 1 mod M. So the choice of M and B is critical and M should be very large and there are rules to choose a suitable B. So basically randomized algorithms are of two types. One is Las Vegas algorithm and the second one is Monte Carlo algorithm. Basically Las Vegas algorithm are the type of randomized algorithm which produces the same output on each execution for the same input, and the Monte Carlo algorithm are the algorithm where the randomized algorithm which produces different output on each execution on the same input. Basically this Las Vegas algorithm is introduced by Laszlo Babay in 1979. Las Vegas algorithm can be used in a situation where the number of possible solution is limited and where verifying the correctness of the candidate solution is relatively easy while calculating the solution is complex. Let us see some of its characteristics. The Las Vegas algorithm always gives the correct output. The running time is bounded by the input size. Sometimes it informs about the failure of the algorithm. So let us say we are having a set of array A1 to AN and we are trying to find how many repeated data are there. So we can take a searching operation. We will compare first element with second to nth element. Then we will take the second element and compare from third element to last. So like that we are going to compare with two different loops. We are going to compare the elements which are repeated. The same algorithm using Las Vegas, we can generate two random numbers mod n plus 1. That is I and j, and if I and j are two different numbers and their values are same, then I can say the value are repeated. So this is how I can use a Las Vegas algorithm to find the repeated data. For the first algorithm, the complexity will be, because there are two loops are there, complexity will be n square, whereas for this Las Vegas algorithm, the complexity will be n log n. Let us discuss about Monte Carlo algorithm. Basically, the term Monte Carlo was first introduced in 1947 by Nicholas Metropolis. And the name refers to the Grand Casino in the Principality of Monaco at Monte Carlo, which is well known for gambling. Let us see some of its characteristics. The Monte Carlo algorithm may not return the answer at all. But let us say we are trying to search if data is existing or not. So here array A is given and we are searching for a small a. So here what we are going to do, we are taking an array and we are checking each element with A, and if it is equal, we are returning it. The complexity will be big O of n. And if we want to use Monte Carlo search, we will take a random number. We'll increase it by 1, and if the data is existing, then we are giving the flag to be true and we are returning the flag. So in this way, if you'll want to do, the output may or may not be correct, because here the while loop we are going to say how many times we are running. look at the input here. Capital A for array, small a for the data, and x is the number of iteration that I want to do. Here is a loop, I is less than equal to x. So it means it is not sure that with x number of iteration I can find the data. So it will not guarantee me a result within a specific number of iterations. So you can see we can use Las Vegas algorithm when there is no time constant at any time, as long as it returns the correct value or the exact result. But we'll perform Monte Carlo algorithm if there is a constant of time. As it has execute a fixed number of iteration, it may not return the exact result. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Keep watching, keep learning. And if you like the video, kindly share with your friends, kindly give likes and comment. So we'll meet in one more video. Till then, take care. Bye.